This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I'm going to talk about using the vertex form to find a quadratic function. So let's say you've got a problem like this. Find the equation of a quadratic function with a vertex at 4, negative 3, and passing through the point 3, negative 5. So since we've been given the vertex for this function that we're looking for, let's use the vertex form to find what the function is. So the vertex form says that p of x equals a times x minus h squared plus k. Now the h is going to be the same as the x coordinate at your vertex, and the k is going to be the same as the y coordinate at the vertex. So we can fill in those values, those numbers. I'm going to have p of x equals a times x, and let's see, the x coordinate is 4, so it's x minus 4 squared plus k, and k was a negative 3, so that'd be minus 3. And then I'm given this other point, 3, negative 5. Now the 3 is an x value, and the negative 5 is a y value. So I can rewrite this, plugging in those values. Instead of p of x, I'm going to put in negative 5. So I'll have negative 5 equals a times, let's see, x is 3. So 3 minus 4 squared minus 3. Now let's see how we can solve this. So I'm going to have, let's add 3 to both sides. So now I've got negative 2 equals a times, 3 minus 4 is negative 1. So I'm going to have a negative 1 squared. Well, negative 1 squared is just 1. So that means that a is going to equal negative 2. So now I can go back here, and instead of an a, I'll put in a negative 2, and that's going to give me the equation for my quadratic function that has a vertex at 4, negative 3, and passing through the point 3, negative 5. Okay, so just to review this quickly, all I did was write down the general formula for the vertex form. That says p of x equals a times x minus h squared plus k. Then I took the values, the numbers for x and y that I have at my vertex, and I plugged those in where I have h and k. And then I used the other point that I had, this was a 3, negative 5, to get x and y values to allow me to find the a. Once I'd found the a, I've basically got the formula for my quadratic function. Okay, that's about it. Take care. I'll see you next time.